Once upon a time, there was an Angular developer named Raqia. Raqia was working on a large and complex application that had many different features and components. One day, Raqia's boss came to her and said, "We need to add the feature that allows users to delete items from the application. But we need to make sure that the users are aware of what they are doing. And we need to give them the ability to cancel the deletion if they change their mind." Raqia thought about this for a moment and said, "No problem, I can add a confirmation dialog to the delete button, and that should do the trick." So she went ahead and added a confirmation dialog to the delete button in the component where the delete feature was located. But as the application grew and more features were added, Raqia realized that she needed to add confirmation dialogs to other parts of the application as well. She started to copy and paste the same dialog code from one component to another. And before she knew it, the code was a mess. The dialogs were not consistent and the code was hard to maintain. That's when Raqia had an idea. She thought to herself, "What if I could create a dialog service that handles all the dialogs in the application? And then I can just use that service in any component that needs a dialog." So she went ahead and created a dialog service, and it was a beautiful thing. The dialog service was responsible for opening and closing dialogs, and it had a consistent look and feel throughout the application. And the best part was that if Raqia needed to create changes to the dialogs, she only had to do it in one place. From that day on, she didn't have to worry about dialogues anymore. She could focus on other important tasks, and her application became more maintainable and user-friendly. So how to implement a dialog service in an Angular application? Let's have a look at the technical details of this kind of service and its usage. Here is the code of the dialog service I have implemented in an Angular app. It's an injectable service that can be used in different modules and components. Its constructor takes in a private variable called dialog of type matDialog. The service has also a method called onClickDelete that takes in two arguments, a callback function, named onConfirmCallback, and an argument of type T. This method is responsible for opening a dialog when the delete button is clicked. It creates a constant variable called dialogData that contains information about the dialog, such as the title, text, and mode of the dialog. The open method returns a reference to the opened dialog, which is stored in the dialogRef constant variable. The afterClosed method of the dialogRef is used to subscribe to the close event. When the dialog is closed and returns a data property with a Boolean value that is true, this means that the user has confirmed the delete action, and that's when the onConfirmCallback function will be invoked with the arg passed in as the parameter. This allows the component that uses this service to perform any necessary actions when the user confirms the deletion. Let's see now how to use the dialog service in the log class mapping component as an example. In the constructor, I have injected an instance of the dialog service. Log class mapping component has a method called onClickDeleteMapping that is triggered when the user clicks on the delete button. This method takes an object with mapping ID and mapping block properties as arguments, and it calls the dialog service's onClickDelete method and passes the emitDelete event function and the event object as arguments. The emitDeleteEvent function is a method that emits the delete mapping block output property, passing the event object as an argument. Log class mapping component has in fact an output property called delete mapping block, which is an event emitter that emits an object containing mapping ID and mapping block as properties when it's called. To avoid ending with the wrong this context when using emit delete event as callback, I have used bind this in the Angular onInit lifecycle hook to bind the emit delete event function to the current this context, which is the correct one. In short, this component is using the dialog service to show a confirmation dialog when the user clicks on the delete button. If the user confirms the deletion, the emitDeleteEvent function is called, which emits the delete mapping block output property and passes the event object as an argument. This allows other part of the application to listen to the deletion event and take appropriate actions. So to sum it up, when it comes to building a large and complex Angular application, keeping your code organized and maintainable is key. And that's where a dialog service came in to save the day. It acts as a one-stop shop for maintaining all your dialogs and model windows, keeping the logic and presentation separate from the rest of your code. Think of it as your superhero swooping to improve your code design and ensuring a smooth and consistent experience for end users, no matter where they are in your application. If you want to elevate your code to the next level, consider implementing this little handy design pattern. Trust me, it's worth it. So that's it, guys. I hope that was helpful. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.